lot of it will depend on the way we talk to the children, and we have to be very reassuring to them. Because see, it's difficult to know what to expect in this time of uncertainty. You know, there was a time when the things had settled and we all felt that, you know, things are going well, but suddenly things are again going topsy-turvy when it comes to the pandemic. So we need to be very careful and very reassuring as to what we say to the children, telling them that let's try to live in the present moment, which is very important. Be thankful for what we have, because 2020, I believe the biggest lesson that 2020 gave to all of us all over the world was the fact that, you know, we actually started the things that we had started taking for granted. We actually started understanding their value. You know what I mean? We started understanding their value. We suddenly developed attitudes of gratitude. And so we need to, you know, tell the child that it's okay. You know, sometimes these kind of situations do happen, and don't panic. So we need to tell them to plan things differently. So for starters, maybe the earlier routine that they used to have, we need to make a little changes in those routine. So we establish a new routine. And along with that new routine, we probably, you know, ask them to make a little list of projects or goals. So there can be creative projects, there could be, you know, or we could just do some kind of life skills. For starters, we can even involve the parents in this process of nurturing and bringing up the children. Because the schools cannot do it alone, the educators cannot do it alone. So it has to be a partnership between the schools, between the parents, between whoever is looking after the child. So the thing is that if we, you know, start doing life skills at home, like for example, how to fix a leaking, you know, some kind of a tap, or maybe, you know, washing the car together, or let's say, you know, planning a family budget, or maybe, you know, virtual tours, you know, you can travel. You cannot travel nowadays, but at least you can travel virtually and then sit down and talk about it. And one of my favorites is that, you know, I always insist and tell parents and, you know, my friends as well, that it's always a good idea to read to the children, read aloud activities amongst the family members. And it's a good time for the family members to connect. Even in school, when they go there, they can have this, these kind of, you know, they could take turns in reading out something and understand that they have to be sitting in a different way. Maybe we can say that, okay, let's, you know, put the classroom in a different, in a creative way. So let's have little circles, or, you know, we have to sort of not get panicked by whatever is happening, but we need to very slowly and reassuringly and comfortingly need to make them comfortable with whatever the situation is. So we need to have these new plans, and similarly, some new simple physical routines. And then, you know, also something about altruism. Maybe they can give those kind of empathetic messages, you know, for well-being, not only for their own friends. Sometimes, you know, their friends could can go into some kind of a depression or just feeling lonely. So they could get together, have those virtual, you know, chats, or do it through a WhatsApp, or like we're meeting a Zoom, and just have a little virtual conference together, just talk together, just, you know, just basically, it's basically what have you been learning, what have you been doing kind of a thing. So these kind of things, and even now, if you see the schooling is also hybrid. Some of the schools that have started are hybrid. So it's not only that, you know, everybody's coming to school, we have to still be very careful. So some kids come to school a day, the others are at home. And how to also, you know, keep this thing going. It's job for educators, you know, I mean, I think they surely have been real big saviors in the times of the pandemic, because home life or whatever life, it was actually a job that demanded 24/7. And the fact that we need to reassure the kids, and, you know, at the same time, not get show our stress to them. I think that was the biggest challenge. And I've known many of my friends and many of the children and many of my, parents also, you know, they have sort of shared this. But the best part was when they shared that, you know, their child actually tried their best to make life a little simpler for their friends who were going through a little depressive phase. So whether they made cards for them online, or they showed some, they did a little program for them online, or they sang songs and did a little role play for their friend online. But it was a fun activity. So, you know, getting used to these new kind of setups, but yet remaining, keeping that legacy alive, that connectedness, that togetherness, that bonding, that camaraderie, keeping that alive.